Okay, this must be here. Adopt the ODA or etc. But
The time that is very separated from maybe 20 years ago, even 5 years ago, the timeline is very separated, and each context of this kind of research was quite different. So that's why I say that the knowledge of this issue is fragmented in Taiwanese context. So this is the first reason I would like to make the similar research, so that we can make the knowledge, even if it's fragmented, but we try to accumulate it. And another perspective is that even we can force these civil servants to adopt this kind of software, because civil servants should be in some kinds, they should be obeyed to their supervisors, because you are civil servants, you are serving for the nation. Nation hire, or your country hires you. But in another perspective, we should care about their subjective feeling about like policy, because we usually maybe you can say it's a kind of another democratic value we are going to conserve. So this is my background of this kind of research. And so my research questions about in this question is, well, the first thing is, how is the adoption progress in Taiwanese government? I hope to get an empirical based data to interpret, and we can interpret it. And second one is their subjective feeling, and whether there are very different attributions. And I will talk about this later in the slides. And so the third question is, if we know these empirical based data we have collected, and we want to know how to improve users' experience and even how to make our policy more better. So these are my, in Taiwanese research, they often use this kind of theory. Is called the theory of behavior. This the many, I saw many dissertations in Taiwan, they use this kind of theory. And in this time, I almost replicated some of their research components. So my, after this kind of replication and modification, I make the brief structure of the questionnaires like this. What is the, whether their view, their attitude is about adopting the audience, this kind of thing is good. And one is, whether they feel they can control yourself, no matter they are using the labor office or permit, etc. And another thing is that whether the condition, no matter it's externally or internally, their condition supports them to do this kind of things. And this, in our cases, is the document interoperability. So this is the brief structure, and I will show you the statistical results afterwards. And I take this survey by the help of Franklin helped me to deliver the questionnaire and in a local government. And so this survey is conducted in about late May to the early June this year. So maybe the context will be a little bit quite different 3 months later, because there is a date September. Some context may be quite different. but I think there we can reference these kind of results too. These results is still referable, I think. And the brief demographic data about the first one is there are many industry level surveys of our respondents. We have in our bureaucratic system, the civil service has about 14 ranks, and these civil servants are usually distributed in one to about nine, rank one to rank nine. They are in professionally so-called the street level bureaucrats. And these people are usually quite young. They are distributed in about, mostly are 30 to 50 years old. And they usually use their computer work for 6 to 9 hours per day. So I mean, maybe I classify them as medium or highly dependent on using a computer. And the fault may be, the character may be small, but you can see the operating system they use is highly mixed. From the newest Windows 10 to some of their Windows 8, and even Windows XP is very outdated operating system. There is still a lot of people use it because my sample is delivered in a relatively remote local government in Taiwan, but they are in Taiwanese context, they are most earlier to adopt OPM policy. That's one phenomenon.
And another one is most even though we know we found most people use LibreOffice, but there are a lot, still a big proportion of people that use OpenOffice.org. Maybe currently we call it Apache OpenOffice. So we found a very quite mixed result of, even though the sample is not very is maybe lack of representativeness. So the data, it depends on how many people and who actually answered our questionnaire, and another thing is whether they are honest in answering the questionnaire. But I hope this kind of response may still help us. We have a very intuitive impression of how people use their computer. And not very surprisingly, but a little bit, how to interpret it is that respondents shows mostly neutral, but they showed a little bit negative attitude to our LibreOffice while they are using it. And let's take a look how is the condition. And first one, this I make a set of the questionnaire, and first one is many people agree that there are too many differences in the way using LibreOffice and Microsoft Office. One civil servant he talked to me privately even about 6 months ago. He said the hard key between the LibreOffice and Microsoft Office is not very jointed, so he feel very interrupted in using some shorts like copy and paste or something. I think this we can make some further research in the user experience part. And another similar question, many people agree it takes them a lot of time getting familiar with LibreOffice. And no matter in the private sector context or in public sector context, making them learning new things will be sometimes very terrible for these civil servants, because they especially in street level bureaucrats in Taiwan, they are very busy in dealing with their daily works itself. So in many contexts, they will feel very painful if they were ordered to keep typing, no matter it is the training course, or even though the speech, like when I am talking like this, they don't like to participate in any other activity, even though they sometimes see this activity waste their time and sometimes useless. But it's still, of course, it has some special context in our civil service training in public administration field. It still needs some further research, but we can, in this case, we can find some way to how to make the civil servants get familiar with the quite new software very quickly. I think this is one thing we can do from this survey results. And another thing is that the software itself may be an internal issue, but how is in Chinese world, we have awareness that if we just make a law and we don't make run it correctly, sorry for it, 无法不足以自行怎么讲会比较好。
Why is only law is not enough?
Only law is not enough in this case, because our information, I heard the case is that he works in a local government and he cannot upload ODF on his information system. The information system only accepts DOCX or XLS format. So he felt very upset because they use the LibreOffice as if they are they feel very can you explain my
disadvantage? Actually, this condition is because we ask people in government to use ODF and LibreOffice, but some of the servers, some of the information website, if you need to upload this video, haven't changed yet.
Yeah, so information system is external to our software itself. But if the information system, it doesn't follow our step to adopt all the things, it will be one obstacle
it will be a big obstacle. And in our academic, in academic field, there will be a potential issue that is that we have to write many papers in the academic journal, right? But if the journal editor, they don't adopt ODM, you will never say, hey, my university, you should adopt ODM, because professors will say, if they don't accept ODM, I cannot use ODM anymore. That's another issue in testing this kind of questions. And we can see a lot of portion of people agree they cannot. If I share files as ODM, I cannot work with my colleague. No matter in his institution or out of institution, and even in civil, in communicating with the citizens. And this in this questions, this question is not very, the very is not very, very obvious, but we can see in many questions the negative opinion is a little bit more than the positive opinion side, and in these questions, is many people still agree that LibreOffice is very hard to use, and many still a big portion of people they feel that they would not like to spend many times working with LibreOffice, but same with there are many similar patterns in the response of my questionnaires, and this questionnaire of testing people's their actual usage, and they admit they use LibreOffice much more less than Microsoft Office. I think they admitted in the questionnaire. So I think the real situation may be much worse than I get on the questionnaire. And of course, it's guess. Maybe it's only my guess. And besides the main results of the questionnaire, there are some interesting discoveries. This one is that most people, when they face the problems while using software, they will not read manual at first. They first ask for their colleagues or IT supervisors for help. And second one is searching for similar cases on the internet. But reading the manual or online, nobody is online or paperback manual. The developer shows is they will never since never showing it as a top priority. This is one of very interesting issue, but very correspondent to many previous research about in the user experience. I think is the first issue we can take notice. And second issue is that sometimes we have a stereotype is that people, the older people, because we think that they don't use very very well computer very well as young people. But my scattering point shows that the younger people seems more resistant to liberal office than the older people. That's another interesting discovery. Maybe in other perspective, we can infer that the younger civil servants may be very more demanding in maybe no matter the software quality, the software stability, etc. than the older people. They were much more or less. They were not compromised to us. Yeah, this is another issue. I think is a little bit is interesting. So there are many similar patterns, even though the pattern is not very obvious. It's still not very obvious that we can take notice. But even that, the actual usage of the comparison makes not very obvious difference. So I turn to another thesis. It's Franklin's countency adopting open document format will be effective. Let's take a look. Whether knowing them, I make about several groups. Is that the first group is that whether they know the policy makes difference. In this kind of two questions, it seems makes difference. Means it can refer that their attitude seems changes if they know the importance of adopting the policy. But and Franklin does a lot of orientations about the policy, but in the attitude toward the making like recommend people using LibreOffice or how to say sorry, Brenda, can you 帮我补充一下？ 就是你说的这个图表的这个。
Oh, yes, 29, 22-9. I think it's a trend to that if people have attended our orientation, or we say it's a new session, talking about ODF policy, meaning behind this policy, they tend to would like to recommend other people, for example.
But the user experience about the software itself is not very
still not
improved. And so another thing is the third group is taking the training course. The user experience, both the user experience and the attitude toward the importance of a policy of open document format has significantly improved. But however, the extent of the improvement is still limited because they still a little bit feel the software quality is a little bit bad. But after the training courses they take part. Only heightened their experience to the almost neutral thing, but not very good. So in another extent, we can say we can infer that the the training course, effect of the training course is still limited. And how to improve the user experience may be another task we can do further after we interpret this kind of research. So I make a brief conclusion and suggestion is that, well, the first one is that, well, training system and documentation is crucial, but improving user experience and user interface, I think it should be another priority. And another issue is that I found an interesting phenomenon is LibreOffice on Linux system as I use now is very stable, but in our Windows system, especially in Chinese Windows system, LibreOffice often shut down in many unexpected way that I've told Frankly a lot of time that. Yeah, so usability test on Windows maybe I think should be more deployed because as we show on the graph, most civil servants they still use Windows as their main operating system. But the bad stability on the LibreOffice on Windows system may make their pressure very bad. This is my main discovery on this survey. And another thing is Stephanie told me is that mitigating the user experience gap between the proprietary software like Microsoft Office and LibreOffice should be another concern because Frankly told me that many developers they never or very seldom use Microsoft Office. I think that's another issue we can make further research. And this research, survey, because this should be not, I said that research so hard. I get help from my faculty in my school and all frankly, but I should take all the responsibility with you and especially my bad English expression. They are my things. They are my faults or mistakes, not their mistakes. Thank you.
Translated.
Yeah, sure. But the meaning was that one. Yeah?
Yes.
Thank you.